Welcome to WHU Inside Business. I have today Frauke Heistermann with me. Frauke is currently a board member of the German Logistics Association and is also a co-founder of Axit. Frauke, thanks very much for coming.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Frauke, you have been responsible for digitalization at Siemens. You've assumed other responsibilities related to digitalization. Based on that experience, what do you think is going to be the impact of digitalization on supply chain and logistics?
Well, I would say there is a huge impact, and there are a lot of possibilities how digitalization will and could influence logistics. On the one hand, I'm absolutely convinced that logistics will play a major role based on digitalization. Logistics managers, logistics people will be able to take over more responsibility based on digital tools they could use, for instance, based on analytics. And I'm proud of that because it's a great chance and opportunity then working on logistics, which is an industry which become more and more important. On the other hand, I think the impact of digitalization is that the cross-company processes will be more automatized, they will be standardized, they will be more transparent based on modern technologies we have.
You mentioned that logistics is going to gain in importance. What does that mean for the capabilities of the logistician? Does that now require a greater technology background, or how is that going to shift over time?
I'm convinced that indeed there will be completely new job profiles in logistics. And there are a lot of new requirements. On the one hand, the understanding of technology. This must not mean that all people need software programming skills, but they should be curious on new technologies. They should have a basic understanding how that works. On the other hand, there are important skills like communication. Also, to define processes along the supply chain based on digitalization, you need communication skills. You need to listen to people to understand what the process drivers are. You need creativity, imagination, innovative interests, how innovation works, and so on. So there is a broad possibility and need of additional skills. I think you will not find them in one person, unfortunately.
Well, unfortunately, or maybe fortunately as well, yeah. Right? Because there's going to be different people working together.
Yeah.
You mentioned technology a number of times. Let's take a look at some of those technologies that are currently very much in the news, like blockchain, like Internet of Things, like deep learning. What's your thought of those technologies?
Well, on the one hand, technologies and those modern technologies, they made logistics managers to change their mindset. That's good, that's great, because this is what we need, to be open-minded toward new technologies and to look for how to integrate them into business processes so that you could create a real value. You mentioned blockchain or IoT. Maybe my personal opinion to blockchain is, it's really hyped. It's nearby celebrated a little bit, but technology is not always the key to solve a problem. And if I hear that people say, based on blockchain, we will have the possibility now to have seamless tracking along the supply chain, the actual hurdles of tracking in the supply chain are not having the right technology. We have it since years. The challenges are to match up the stakeholders on one table. And there are hundreds of different stakeholders along the supply chain for one single supply chain. And to convince them to digitize their data and not to manual entry them somewhere, to motivate them to share their data. That's not obvious. In the opinion of different companies, they are not always willing to share their data. And also to teach them what we expect regarding data quality. And in all those three hurdles, blockchain will not help us. The human beings need to be integrated and help us to take care with that. On other issues, blockchain will help us for sure concerning smart contracts and digitalizing of trust and so on. Concerning IoT, I love that topic. I love it to have the imagination that in future, pallets, materials, they will send us the necessary data by their own, which would help us to get better data, and which would also help us to cope with the actual black holes within the supply chain. So there are a lot of technologies in the digital age of supply chain, but it's not the only key of success, having the right technology.
Right, absolutely. Now, what is your thought in terms of digital transformation? Are smaller firms at an advantage, possibly because they might be more agile, or at a disadvantage when it comes to benefiting from digitalization? What is your thought on that as compared to larger companies?
Based on my experience as working in management of companies in logistics industry, I made the experience that bigger, larger companies, that they are more professional in coping with digitalization. In most cases, larger companies have got a strategy. They have got sources, people to do that strategy. They have got sources to investigate what a new technology means. They have got time and sources to investigate what could be new business models. Unfortunately, and I do not really understand why, but unfortunately, I made the experience that smaller companies, they are not so open-minded. Maybe they have not enough resources, but they often have fear concerning new technologies, and they develop not so far and fast as they should in the age of digitalization. I don't know really why this is, because you could start digitalization small on a low base of money. But yeah, my personal experience is the bigger a company is, normally the faster they are. Well, they have the possibility to invest maybe more money, but it's not all about money. It's also about having innovative ideas, and that must not cost a lot.
Right. Can an association like the German Logistics Association kind of level the playing field, or is that maybe too much of an expectation?
No, why not? Why not? Because it's often about having the right knowledge, mm-hmm. And getting best practices to better understand what could that mean for my own company. And this is something indeed what the Logistics Association is doing and could do even more, and also explaining what does a new technology mean, what does digitalization mean, and so on. So being a distributor of knowledge and information, sure, this is something where they are strong in.
Frauke, thanks very much for the interview.
It was a pleasure.